Friends and colleagues, welcome back to the next episode of Light Inner Flame. In the earlier episode, we had spoken about being aware of yourself. And Rashida told us how to do this. So Rashida, what is the next step? After you are being aware of yourself, what do you do next to light that inner flame?
First step to being aware, bring in awareness in our very being, is through meditation, which is the most natural way of acquainting yourself with your own higher self, of being aware of your life and of the happenings in your life. Meditation is that one deep state that you can be in all your life, all the time, through whatever you're doing.
That's very interesting, Rashida. So you say meditation is the next step to being aware, right?
Yes, meditation is the very next step of awareness itself. But meditation by itself is not easy. People will tell you that they can't meditate, to sit in one place for a long time and not to think about anything and then still feel good about everything that is happening in your life. It is not easy. Many people refrain from meditation just because there's a little thought in your mind that you have to sit still and not do anything, not say anything, especially not think of anything, which is not possible on a human level. Yeah, we are so bogged down, we are so influenced with our fluctuating lifestyle that with the worries of the world of finance and work and relationships and so many things. It's not easy to steady our minds to focus on any one thing. So the best thing is to be aware of that. Yeah, whatever you do, be a part of that. Focus your mind on that.
So Rashida, how does one start meditating? Could you guide us?
Meditation itself is what? Basically, it is having your focus on something. You're attending to something in particular. So you can do that throughout your life for every little thing. When you're jogging, you jog. When you're talking, you have full attention of the other person, as well as the other person should have your full attention when you're talking. When you're eating, you enjoy the food. Hear the sounds around you, smell the flowers or the air or the perfume that is around you. Now use your senses to the fullest. Breathe in. Most important part is to know whether you're breathing or not. Breathe in smoothly. Fill your stomach, fill up like a balloon. Breathe out, exhale smoothly. Take a few breaths like that for just 5-10 breaths would really make you feel that, oh, you are alive. Your life has a meaning. This body has a purpose over here. That itself will make you feel alive, help you to start focusing. Then no matter what you do throughout the day, you can bring your focus into that particular activity. Thoughts, they are part of your life. You can never do away with them. So even when you're meditating quietly, sitting in one place, let the thoughts come in. Enjoy the thoughts. Be an observer, but don't get involved in thinking further. Let that come. Bring your focus to your breath. See whether you're breathing. Inhaling smoothly, enjoying the breath going in. Exhaling smoothly, enjoying the breath coming out. Let the thoughts come and go. Let them do their job. You enjoy your breathing. And then slowly bring your focus on your breathing. And then you can actually put a particular thought that you would like to focus on, where you can really work your way around that. Maybe it's an idea, maybe it's a solution to a problem, maybe it's something in a relationship that you need to work out. You can actually start focusing then, and then you will see you will get answers, because now you're able to focus your mind on something. But it has to be on a day-to-day basis. It's not just about sitting in one place, but every activity has to be meditated upon. Whether you're drinking a glass of water to feel the texture of the water, the taste of the water, the color of the water, you have to truly experience every little thing that you do in your life. That will start bringing your focus in the present on the thing that you're doing. The focus will be on your activity that you're actually doing at that time, enjoying it. That itself is a meditative state, by the way. It is a Zen way that whatever you do, whether it is cooking, cleaning, washing, gardening, anything, keep your mind at that particular activity, keep your mind on that particular point in that particular time. That itself is meditation.
So what you're saying is that one can start practicing meditation by first just breathing. Breathing deeply in, breathing deeply out. And then once that starts, you start focusing on something, focusing on anything. And the best thing to do is focus on what you are doing. Whatever you're doing needs to be focused on. And that itself is meditation.
Absolutely. See, it's like when you're cooking, can you be somewhere in your office doing any work? No. So then why not focus on the cooking? And when you're in the office, you cannot be at home doing anything. So focus on your work in the office. Emergencies happen, that time we do manage. But on a day-to-day basis, we can be at only at one place at one time doing one thing, right? So why not focus at that point of time on that activity which you've already undertaken? It is not that you're not aware of that, right? So focus on that. Automatically, that is meditation. Because now your mind is focused on one particular thing that needs to be done, which is important for you. And you can do it beautifully, knowing that your full heart and mind is in that activity. And then you find your ways to work that around. When you're at home, be with the family, be in the activity that you're doing, enjoy the time at home. Yeah, stop worrying about the office. Emergencies are separate things, but on a day-to-day basis, we cannot sail on two different boats at the same time. You have to be at any one particular point in a particular place doing a particular activity. Multitasking to some level is fine, it is good. We do admire those people, but truly, when it is not needed to multitask, why really pressurize oneself for doing that? It's really not important. Meditation is that you really focus on one thing, be there in the present with your thoughts, with your mind, with your activity. At that particular time, you're meditating, you are meditating. You're cooking, you are cooking. You're washing, you are washing. You're walking, you are walking. You are jogging, you're jogging. When you're jogging on the road, when you're walking on the road, admire the beauty around you, the people passing by, smile at them. See the feet touching the ground when you're jogging. Feel that. Feel the heat when you're, you know, really working out. Feel that. What is happening in your body? Let your senses absorb whatever is happening in your environment. By doing that particular activity, that is meditating in a way. And then once this focusing will deepen with every activity, with every action of yours, a time will come that you really enjoy just being in one place, enjoying just being by yourself. Even then the thoughts are coming, they will no more disturb you, rather slowly you will be able to silence them in a way that you will enjoy even that beautiful, quiet, state of mind that you can be. The body and mind is in your control. Don't let the body and mind control you. That is the whole idea.
Wow, wonderful. So meditation is as simple as living life, and it can become a very major part of your life, and one should start meditating immediately. So being aware and meditation. Thank you very much, Rashida. You have actually made things which people find complicated, very simple.
Life is a meditation. So enjoy the meditation as your life. As simple as that.
Thank you very much, Rashida, for this little gem of knowledge. And we hope to talk more with you next time and learn more about how to light the inner flame. Friends, keep watching this series of ours. It's also available on podcast. And subscribe to our channel, so that we can reach you immediately the next time we are on air. Thank you very much. Thank you, Rashida.
Thank you for having me. Have a great day.